Talk about getting our mutant boson. Come to you high atop Indica Springs, Colorado. And I mean high. At No Authority Field, home of the Mile High Chronic. Just bought some of those brownies at the Get Baked sale. Man, these guys can bake up here.
I can hear callers, Grim. Hey, Grim, order me one of them corned beef and hash oil sandwiches. I got the munchies something bad.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Blitzburg Steelheads battle the Mile High Chronic. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Go Steelheads! Go Steelheads!
And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pink flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
Nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
Second down in a mile. He had it for a second there. Third down and forever.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
And that was well played. The defense anticipated a pass and put... You gotta be fucking kidding me. If that's a penalty, they should come up here and penalize us, too.
Hey, don't give these refs any ideas, you idiot. Brent, hide the stash.
On it. And the punter takes a defense, says enough of this BS, and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys.
I don't understand. Why are they going for it, Grim? This seems like the situation where they should always...
He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. First down and six.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot.
Oh, the strawberry field's dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics, or insanity to anyone, but they've always worked for me. Second down and seven.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two.
Cornerback is down.
Zoom in on his face. I want to see if the little bastard's crying.
Hey, okay, no, man, I can't. Jim on that. Yep, get on the gap. Get on out. Get on.
Third down, and well, good luck.
Hot one.
Six-yard game there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. It's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. And they run it for a couple of yards. Third down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. Put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And that'll be second and 8 to go.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot, hot three.
He got rid of it out of bounds. That's better than throwing a pick, I suppose. Third down and 8.
Hot. Hot one, hot two, hot, hot three.
And then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end.
It's about time, Grim. The boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
first down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First down and one. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. The runner pulls out a first and 10. They could not connect on that play. Second down and 10. Like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and 10. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and 3. Put on a display there. Touchdown. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Briggs. It means he can return for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. Third down and long. Oh, he's going berserk. The ball carrier better watch out, because if he gets hit, he is dead. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Oh, with a punishing hit. It's first and 10. They run it for a yard. Bricks, it's the 2-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
Second down and 9. There aren't too many players that kids can look up to it. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stopped after 3.
They usually stop me after 3, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffet.
And they take their first timeout.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. For a 1st down. They use their 2nd timeout, but they are running out of time.
Bit pessimistic, don't you think so, Grim?
It's more about building tension, Bricks. That's all we do at this point. And drink this bourbon. Come on, give me that. When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Anyone said never hit a man when he's down? He's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
First and 10. And he rumbles for 9 on that play. The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1.
Hot 1. Hot 2.
1st down! And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
Yeah, tell him me! Nice run!
No, I mean, he's a real stud. He works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers.
Hot 1. Hot 2. Hot.
He caught it! And nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. In a hurry up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. And it's first. The quarterback is controlling the clock like. is into it. I know I am. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. And it's good!
You know, Grim, in this league where murder and bribery are cheered, it's good to be good, huh? I mean, can we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
He is fighting for every yard. It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, during the half, can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
And they're taking the field for the second half, and we have got a tie score.
Speaking of tie, Grim, me and Hot Wanda, we wanted to try something different, so we tied each other up the other night, and nothing happened because we were both tied up. I don't understand what the big deal is.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and ten. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and four. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten. Up the first down. And the offense says, I don't think so. They called a time warp dirty trick and negate that previous play like it never happened.
Did it? Does that mean that I didn't just chug this beer too or wet myself? I am so confused.
He just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peckerhead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Second down and ten. They pick up and the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
And that'll bring up third down and seven. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pat. I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned NFL rule. Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. miracle. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. He wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye.
I'm not saying the ref has been bribed, but he drove out of the field in a brand new hearse.
First and 8 to go. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowd's loving it. First and 4. And he gets 3 yards on that run. That'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's 1st and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
2nd down in a very lot. Well, good luck. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's 1st and 10. Simple game when it comes down to it. And it's 1st and 10. He blasts it and picks up 7 yards right there. Second and 3. What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done.
Good game for talent.
There are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and 10. Oh, nice hit. That's the way you do it. Let them have it and then take it away. Down and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckle.
Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
Second down and long. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. Broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
The defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boost Dirty Trick. And 3. And he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
First down and 1. Vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. And that'll bring up third and one. All week the quarterback said they'd blow up the defense today. He was right. Kapow! And he lines up for the field goal attempt, trying to ignore the defense's threats of murder. He's got the distance, and the kick is good! They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. Man, what a hit that was! And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And the defense.
I'll be turkey down. Players getting chased with chainsaws.
To the races. He's at the 40. The 30. Here comes the defense. He's in, and this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down. And it's first and 10. The extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear the kicker grin.
This guy in the field.
How? I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
Boom! First and 10. And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. They stop the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have nine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Oh, and that's when it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out,
quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. Second down and 5. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste sound but can't remember what the concept of time is. Quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. just put on a display there. Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and, they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
The Mile High Chronic lose the game. They fought tooth and nail, but in the end, lose by three. It's a hell of a thing losing at home.
They took away all they've got and all they're ever gonna have.
Yeah, well, they played like shit. Fuck them.
Fuck them indeed, Junior. Let's go down the field and see what that meathead has to say about his MVP award. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...